What if you were able to organize and review all the tasks that you need to get done on a project, and at a glance, you know exactly what the status is, who's doing it, what the priority is, a tool that kept you highly efficient and in control? In today's video, I want to introduce a template that we use for our clients to manage all their projects. This template isn't ClickUp. You know how much I love ClickUp. I have lots of videos talking about ClickUp as a project management tool for interior designers. So if you want more information, check out the other videos. Hey, I'm Chris, director of KVM Interior Design, an online firm that supports interior designers worldwide with their workload. By outsourcing to us, the designers can free up some of their time to work on the key tasks on their projects, but they can also free up time to rest and spend time with their family, recharge and feel more creative. And as a result of delegating to us, they're able to grow their businesses without working harder. For this video, we're actually going to go onto the computer. I'm going to introduce the ClickUp template to you. And if you have any questions, just leave a comment below. And if you like the video, subscribe, like it, comment. And yeah, let's go.
All right. So now we're on the computer and I'm going to introduce the ClickUp template for project management. So when you get the template, if you get it as a digital product, or if you start with the one-on-one setup, what you'll get is basically this space. So all of this is for my business, so it's not relevant. But what you'll get is this space, system setup for interior designers. And then what you have when you open it are four folders. The first one is where you will have all your client projects. So we just have templates that we're using now that I will show you how they work. Then you have procurement and order tracking. This is just internal stuff. So whatever you want to have in there, you can have. And then inactive clients or maybe projects that are done that you don't want to keep in this folder, you can move to this one. So in the client folder, this is the template that we use. You can just duplicate when you want to create a new one for a new project, for a new client, and then you can change the name. So I just created another one that's called client 2. Just for the purpose of showing you today what we're gonna do. And what is really nice with this template is that it's already organized by stages of the project. So first, I mean, we have information and project management admin, but then we have the onboarding, kickoff meeting, design. So this is the design development, install, and project close of boarding. So we will start adding all the tasks that you generally do when you get a project so that you don't forget anything. And this is good because you're going to start basically building a process for how you do things. And every time you get a project, you should use the same process. That's how you will get more efficient, more organized. You will give your clients a better client experience. And you will spend less time trying to figure things out because you will know exactly what it is that you need to get done. So what's interesting here is that when you're going to start adding all the tasks that you need to do for the onboarding, for example, you know, like send contract, this is maybe a Dubsado task. So it's really nice that everything has a tag and you can obviously change the tags. You're going to be able to see, okay, the contract is on the Dubsado, which is a CRM tool, and you know it has to get done there. You can check the progress, the phase is the onboarding. You could still switch it to something else, but obviously the send contract is going to be during the onboarding phase. You can add a due date. You can estimate how long the task takes. Obviously for this, like if you're automating using the Dubsado, there are a lot of tasks that you won't need to do manually. For the contract, it will have to be personalized because each client is different. But still, like it's gonna be more organized if you do all those things via the Dubsado. And you can check out my other videos for the Dubsado and what it is and how to use it. But yes, so scheduling a visit, we do that on the Dubsado as well. So everything that's relating to the client and those things like sending an invoice or a contract will be done via the Dubsado. It's still really nice to have that in ClickUp because you know that it's been like it's being taken care of, and you have a full overview of the project. You could also decide that you want to add notes here, or you could assign the task to someone else. And for each task, So let's go maybe to a design task. For example, this one, the tag is KVM because the designer is delegating the rendering task to our team. You can add a priority, you can add a delegating date. So this is nice because, for example, let's say you have a presentation 2 weeks from now. So you will add the date of the presentation and you can add a date that you have to send the brief to your delegating team so that you get the renders on time before your presentation. You can add people to your team, so you can assign different tasks to different people. And I also think it's really nice when your dashboard with your contractors or vendors or even clients, because then you could ask them to review or you could ask them to upload their site photos so that you have that on file. So then assignee, designer status. So those are some of the statuses that can be used. Here you go. If it's being worked on, if it's waiting for feedback, the progress, and you can add more columns if you wanted to. So that's it. I mean, ClickUp is amazing because it's easy to customize. So when you click on the general folder, at a glance, you can see all the tasks that are overdue, all the tasks that are due today, tomorrow, in the future, and you can see the due date. So it means that for every client, you don't need to go into each dashboard, into each list. You can just stay on the general folder and you know exactly what you need to issue in the next, in the coming days. You can change it to board, but if you click on calendar here, you can see in calendar view everything that you need to get done. And then if you click on it, obviously it's going to tell you for which client it is. It's going to give you everything, the designer status, the fees, the progress. So if someone starts tracking, it's going to show up here, like what the progress is on this task. You can add attachments, tasks, subtasks, and you can communicate here. So for example, if you're assigning a task to one of your clients, you could then communicate here and have a full-on conversation instead of having to write each other emails. You can also start a Zoom meeting if you've connected your ClickUp to Zoom. And then same thing for the procurement. For when it comes to that phase of the project, you can add for each room. So this is how we decided to set it up, right? But for each room, you can add all the pieces of furniture or fixtures that you need to buy. And you can then track what the progress is. So for instance, here you can add, you know, if you need to follow up, if you have a VA, maybe you want to assign those tasks to her. Status, what is the status? Is it ready to order? Is it back ordered? Is it in production? Is it being shipped? What is the client status? Has it been paid? Has a deposit been paid? What's the vendor? What's the invoice number? What's the carrier? When is the completion date? When is it getting on site? And who's the receiver? Is it the client home? Is it a warehouse? So this is an amazing tool to keep yourself super organized and know at a glance what is going on your projects. And if you have a VA or an outsourcing team, they can just jump in and they know exactly what is happening. They don't need to ask you a million questions. The first option is to do the one-on-one setup with our expert, and she's going to modify this template to match your business needs. If you buy it as a digital product on our website, you can modify it yourself to your needs. Obviously, the financial investment is going to be a little bit different. So if you have any questions, let me know. If you like the video and you want to know more, drop me a comment, like the video, subscribe for more tips and for more tutorials.